Can you get to the Whitsundaes for free?
Yes, that is possible. I did it, and I will tell you all about it coming up.
Oh, mama, I'm gonna make it. Mama, I'm gonna make it. Oh, mama, I'm gonna make it.
Let's forget this land of worries. Spend an evening by the sea. I'm a sucker for the sunset. And the waves, they set me free. And I say, don't stop now.
Welcome back. As you know, if you've seen my last video, I'm in Airlie Beach working in a hostel for free accommodation because yes, if you're planning to do this, you do need a little bit of time. So I was lucky enough to work for free accommodation so I wasn't losing any money. I could just stay there for free while I was trying to figure this out. So as in many other hospitality jobs, when you're trying to get a job, you usually have to go through an unpaid trial. So you work there for free for about 2 hours so they can see who you are, how you work, and if you're a good fit for the job. So they do the same thing with these boats that go out to the Whitsundaes, but you can't just go and work on these boats for 2 hours because they leave the harbor. So you actually have to go with them and you stay for the whole entire trip. And usually that's 3 days and 2 nights. But there's many, many different trips, many different boats that go out to the Whitsundaes. So you do kind of have to be open-minded with what boat you go with. I was actually really lucky because I got to go with Solway Lust. And this is a beautiful, beautiful old sail ship.
There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Billy of Tea. The winds blew up her bow, dip down, oh blow, my bully boys blow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
Let me give you some brief history on this boat because it's really, really cool. Solway Lust was built back in 1902, so it's over 120 years old, and it has been all over the world. It is one of the most iconic ships that sails the Whitsundaes, and here's some of the crazy things that happened to it. She was built in the Netherlands. That's probably why I felt right at home when I boarded the ship, but she has actually lived through both the world wars. Isn't that crazy? So after the First World War, she was taken by the British as a war prize. With the outbreak of the Second World War, Solway Lust was seized by the German Navy, where she was used as a supply ship until she was sunk by a German mine. Unfortunately for Solway Lust, she sat at the bottom of the ocean as a wreck until the conclusion of the war, where she was hauled from the bottom to be fixed and reused. So this ship has been laying on the bottom of the ocean for years, and then all of a sudden they decide to take it back up to fix it and reuse it. How awesome is that? All the history that's there, you can almost feel it when you walk on board this ship. If these walls could talk, oh my goodness, the stories it would tell. The things it has seen. So cool. But anyway, I was there to have some fun. So, one of the first things that you do when you go to the Whitsundaes is you have to go and snorkel.
Out with you right next to me.
I wanna go.
Feel the pounding of your heartbeat. When we get up high, won't look down, we won't look back. Yeah, when I die, I wanna know I lived like that.
I wanna run in wide spaces, fly like the wind in high places, rushing like water on my face. With your hand in my head.
We actually went and jumped off of the boat.
I wanna know you did them too. Baby.
Yeah, I wanna run in wide spaces, fly like the wind in high places, rushing like water on my face. With your hand in my head, I wanna get into the moment. Kiss it like you never did, kiss the phone.
With your
head in my head. I wanna run in wide spaces, fly like the wind in high places, rush like water on my face. With your
I can see you right now, like a sunset on the ocean. Dreaming out loud with the eyes wide open. The nights are magic and the days are golden. I just gotta say it now, there's nothing better than this. Moments we'll never forget. The kind of feeling money can't buy. And it's such a good life that we live, we live, we live. There's nothing better than this.
After that, we hoisted the sails. Is that how you say that?
I think so. I don't know all these sailing terms. I'm not sailing a vagabond.
I didn't expect this, but this was a whole experience because it's a huge boat. And to be able to move that forward by just the wind, they actually let the guests help with the sails. And the crew members had to climb into masts to actually untie the sails.
Whitsunday Beach, and Whitsunday Beach is actually the prettiest beach in the whole entire world. I know it's been named that a couple of times. I'm not sure if it's still the prettiest beach. In my opinion, it is, but let me just show you so you can decide for yourself.
We're living the best life, living such a good life. Every day's a beautiful day. Walking on the bright side, memories in real time, pictures that never fade away. I can see you right now, like a sunset on the ocean. Dreaming out loud with the eyes wide open. The nights are magic and the days are golden. I just gotta say it now, there's nothing better than this. Moments we'll never forget. The kind of feeling money can't buy. And it's such a good life that we live, we live, we live. There's nothing better than
this. Actually also known for this random tree trunk that's on the beach. And another fun thing is actually the breeding ground for sharks.
If time is ours forever,
and it's better you can spent find stingrays there.
Every second making it last. Oh, this feeling that it gives me, endless new beginnings. Where we go, there's no looking back. I can see it right now, like a sunset on the ocean. Dreaming out loud with the eyes wide open. The nights are magic and the days are golden. I just gotta say it now, there's nothing better than this. Moments we'll never forget. The kind of feeling money can't buy. And it's such a good life that we live, we live, we live. There's nothing better than this.
Volunteering, I actually got to get really close with the staff, and because they go there every single time, they actually know all the ins and outs, and they took me to this other random unknown place where there is a hammock and you have this beautiful view, and the ocean is just so blue.
We'll never forget the kind of feeling money can't buy, and it's such a good life that we live. Oh, there's nothing better. Moments we'll never forget.
So, yes, I know, you're working there as a volunteer. You might be thinking, what are all the things that you have to do? Are you actually busy? Do you even get to enjoy your time when you're on the boat? For sure, yes. Secondly, I literally barely had to do anything. All I was there for was to help out with the cook when she was cooking. But honestly, I barely had to do anything because she loved to just be left alone in the kitchen. So I did do the dishes and I set the tables and I brought the food out. So you get there a couple of hours earlier before the whole trip starts to do the big cleanup. And I think I cleaned the bathrooms only once in between the whole trip. And then when everything is finished, you do a big cleanup again for an hour or two. But honestly, that's it. Like, that's barely anything. When I was on the boat, I literally could just chill and hang out with the guests and with the staff. So you kind of also get all the ins and outs and behind the scenes. And that was really cool. So honestly, it didn't even feel like I was working at all. I was having way too much fun. And unfortunately, that means that the time absolutely flew by. And before I knew it, it was already time to leave again. I can definitely, definitely, definitely recommend this to everyone. If you have the time, this is absolutely an experience that you don't want to miss. This and Fraser Island are my two absolute favorite experiences of the whole entire East Coast trip. This is absolutely worth every single penny if you do have to pay it. So go sign up. You are definitely missing out if you don't. So take on the adventure and don't forget, love always, and I will see you next week.
She had not been 2 weeks from shore when down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow. The wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.